Hello there, everybody. It is Flash Player, and welcome back to more Banjo-Kazooie. Today, it's gonna be an odd day, I can tell right now. Today we're going into the spider webbery place around these black green grape things, and we're going to, open this note door. 511. Now, you're probably wondering why I'm not heading into Gabby's Valley. I said it again! You're probably wondering why I'm not heading into Gobi's Valley. Because, I wanted to do things different for once, because almost all LPs do Gobi's Valley before Mad Monster Mansion, and since you actually have a choice, I'm going to be doing Mad Monster Mansion first, just because I feel like it, and I've never done it that way before. So, follow my path if you want to do that too. There's this product, and when I'm nice and slim once more, burgers, fries, and chips! I think she said galore. I am really sad that I cut that off, because that was one of my favorite rhymes ever. That was, like, the best grunty rhyme, hands down. She thinks she can just skip all the work, and once she steals Tootie's beauty, then she can apparently eat all the junk food once again. I find that kind of funny, because that's sometimes people's mentality. Well, no real people's mentality, but I mean, you know, the video game characters that you sometimes talk to on weekends. Yeah, you know those ones, huh? Okay, we're going up here, and this is one of the parts I don't like in the game. They have quite a few of these places. They're just jump, no pull. Anyway, here is the puzzle for Mad Monster Mansion, and we're going to fill it in by pressing Z and use 10 stinking puzzle pieces on it. Puzzle freaks. Mad Monster Mansion, there we go. Now, finding this is going to be a little bit of a challenge. I actually don't know why they put it in the place they did, because I don't think anybody in their right mind could find it. It actually took me. I mentioned before that I was 7 while I was finding this or something. But by the time I actually found this was when I was 11. It took me 4 years to find Mad Monster Mansion. I am not kidding. I was so desperate, I was looking in Treasure Trove Cove for it. No, I'm not kidding. Okay, today, we are going to head into Mad Monster Mansion, which is out this pipe, and back where we were starting, where we found the Gobi's Valley picture, there I said it right, is actually where Mad Monster Mansion, the opening to the world, is. So that's where we're going to be heading next, as soon as we get out of this dismal pool. There is a lot of water from this point on in Grunty's lair, so look out. After over here, yeah, in the witch face is where we're gonna go next. But one thing I want to show you first, this is a honeycomb box with bees all around it. Now, those bees won't just sit there and say, my business is none of your beeswax or whatever. They're gonna chase you, and they're gonna sting you. The only way to get rid of them is Wonderwing. Anyway, we've opened up a second cauldron, which is the same color as the first one. That's it, you've created a shortcut. Hop in and see. No, thank you, I'd rather not right now. I'm trying to be polite, but I gotta shut you up somehow. Okay, back into the lava place, which nobody likes. Everybody doesn't like the lava place, because you can just fall into lava and all that. And no, you can't fall off this side. I was just checking there really quickly. Here's Gobi's Valley, and the music starts playing epically. I like the remix, that kind of remix of Grunty's Lair. Looking at the computer screen right now, it really looks quite a bit brighter than the TV screen. I'm gonna have to be careful, because really I can't see where I'm going. Just looking at the computer screen, hoping that I can get through this. There we go. Okay, now in here you can see the walls start to turn a lightish teal, which is Mad Monster Mansion. Tootie says she's fine with me. If you go home, I'll set her free. Yeah, right. Why would we go home and then she'd be set free if she was fine with you? Some of Grandtilda's rhymes just don't make any sense. It's kind of weird. But they were cleverly thought up. I bet the person who thought those up got like 10,000 bucks a rhyme. That was the kind of pay I would have to take. Anything look odd about these graves? Well, there's rip on them, but that's with all graves, too. The enemies aren't here yet, so I'm just heading in. Sorry, I'm feeling kind of stuffed up today. Oh, okay. We are now in Mad Monster Mansion, which is a favorite of mine. Although it's down, it's on the bottom of my list of favorites. If you can imagine. That is creepy. These two guests are rather dumb. Let's make sure they're unwelcome. Up there is Napper, one of the creepiest ghosts in the game. You do not want to wake him up. I'll kill you! No, you won't. I'm just kidding. He will actually just wake up and yell at you to get off his lawn. You can listen or not, but you'll probably die. Excuse me. Now, we are going back in, and the only way to get there without waking him up is, as you might imagine, climbing up onto the roof. Which you can do by these little pool things. Yeah. Over there. And the shock spring will take you to the higher level, which is actually going to be to the top level of the roof. Now, there's two chimneys here. One is a little one, which I don't think we could really fit down, so I think there's one right up here, up on the shingles, that I'm going to get to in a minute. That's only one ginger out of five, though, so we still got a lot to find. Yep, drop in through here, and you will land narrowly in a fireplace, which you were just about to get hit by, so that was kind of freaky. So there's Napper's butt over there, and we have got to get past him without waking him up. So, get on these chairs, because you can't hear the rattle of chairs. And boom! Yikes! Grunty's gold. Oh, it's shone. She'll be mad. Now it's gone?
Yes, I'm mad, my boot I'll put. Up your useless spooky butt.
That was like a crude rhyme. Okay, one jiggy, and now we are in the courtroom. No, it's not a courtroom, it's the dining room. What am I thinking? Of the Mad Monster Mansion. That is like the freakiest picture of Mumble alive. I'm sure glad they didn't keep that design. I bet you guys are freaking out right now because that was actually a beta design of Mumbo, which is really, really kind of freaky that they were actually going to use that in the game. Back out into the main area, well, we get some fresh 300-year-old air. I wonder how old the air around us is. One of those scientific questions. I have no clue. Anyway, you can break the lighted windows to get into them and break into places like these. There's a picture of Grantilda, but look out, because there are those bone chomper things in there. Hands down, my favorite enemy in the game. They're just awesome. And right here is a picture I want to show you. Captain Black Eye. We'll be covering him in a later LP. So, back out the window. We are 8 minutes into this episode and we haven't gotten much done. Okay, there is a swooper up there, or not a swooper. Swooper is the Mario enemy. There is a, I don't know what that's called. Anyway, we'll bust open the wine cellar and get in there, because the wine cellar is a pretty cool place. Actually, I think this wine isn't even here anymore. So anyway, we can get these notes and break open all these caskets that say 1800s on them, which is kind of foreshadowing how old this place is. This is like over 100 years old. There are the Jinjo, the second Jinjo, I should say, and a golden feather, and boom! We'll break open that casket to find a couple eggs, like that was worth it. And this, that doesn't have anything in it. So next one, Mumbo Token. Mumbo Tokens are very valuable, keep them. And there's the Jiggy in one of them, so that's an easy gotten Jiggy. That would be a pretty cool thumbnail, I bet that would be cool. So I'm going to use Wonder Wing, destroy him right now, and yep, there we go. Now, looking in there, that is a secret place that we'll be covering later. I keep giving away these hints, even though I don't want to. So, I'm not going to say the right... Whoa. You were waiting for your share of blood there, weren't you? This episode, it's getting really creepy. I should stop. It's just like... Just saying that gives me the chills. He was waiting for his, I don't know what he was waiting for. Okay, over here is a whole bunch of graves, and there's actually... If you put a couple eggs into these guys, they'll sprout flowers if you can aim right. What you want to probably make sure you're full on eggs before you try this. There is a controversy about this place in the game that they are actually swearing at you when you fill them up all the way. Which, no, that one didn't fill up all the way. But they are not. It's obvious to see they are not. Let's slow this part down right here. Listen to this. So we can see right there that he obviously wasn't swearing. Let's go fill the rest of these up right now because I want to get out of... a walking grave. When a grave gets up and walks towards you, I don't recommend, like, going and smashing into it. That probably won't make it have a nice day at all or anything, which will probably make it have an angry disposition towards you. Ooh, boy. These graves are really, like... What joke can I make here? They're really gray, they're under the weather. There's a better joke, I know it. Wow, we got it in! That was like a 10. That was a 10. You guys leave your jokes for the graves. I need more audience feedback. Because we need more grave jokes in the world. Actually, that's kind of disrespectful, but these ones, it's okay. Because nobody actually died here. So anyway, we're farting eggs into these, and hopefully they fill up soon. Yay! Filled up. Okay, now on to this one, which are... I thought we filled them all up, but I guess there was one we left, so I'm gonna have to look for it. I wonder where that is. There's old rickety gates around here that you can blow open easily. But I guess we'll deal with those later. Where is it? It's gotta be... Oh, a Mumbo Token. That's pretty cool. I love Mumbo. Hey, there you go. Okay, I love Mumbo Tokens. They're just so easy to collect here. I think you need 20, actually, to turn into the transformation for this world. Whoa. Thank you, dude. Thank you. Okay, and that is 3 Jiggies. Hooray. Now we can move on, I guess, to more different things. Like finding secrets in the graveyard. Such as over here in this Banjo-Kazooie window. You can actually go right through it. It is a transparent window. I've never heard of such a thing either. Don't ask me. And this is a great place also to fill up on your feathers and eggs and lives and everything in the whole wide world that you want to fill up on. Right now I got like 30 eggs, 40 feathers, as you can probably read off this, which is pretty amazing pickup. I really like this place. Now we're going to try to make our way back out of here so we can get... Whoa! See these swoopers? They just... I'm going to call them swoopers because I like that name. See these swoopers? They're just like sitting all around here waiting for us to come out. That's freaky. That's a bit glitchy there. We can't even get through that. Up here, there's a couple of skeletons, which is kind of scary to me. But they're nice skeletons, children. That's okay. They're nice. Okay, we break this door open, and there is in here a kind of piece. It says, "Greetings, O Solid One. I'm Tumblr, the mighty solve the... Oh, the mighty solve the puzzle, and if you take this infernal thing that's stuck under me..." I read that as a fail. Okay, here we... A little blip in the recording right there. Here we, have to spell Banjo-Kazooie with the letters over here. Which is, like, a really weird game that you have to spell something right or you die. I've never really liked those kind of games that they play at school. So, we spelled Banjo with 52 seconds left. Now we just gotta find the K. And watch out for the Grublum Ghost. He's a purple one, which apparently means he likes to run around in random ways and run into people. And as we all know, that was not scripted. So, kazoo. Ooh. What comes after O? Another O. That's confusing. I think we're going to make it here. We got 24 seconds left, and there's the I. Ouch. If you hit the grunty spaces, you're going to get hurt, just reminding you. Let's take our leisurely little time on this E, as at last the puzzle is solved. Take this thing. I'm leaving this gloomy place. Shed. I shouldn't try to read ahead. There is the Jiggy that we have all been waiting for. This has been Flash Flare, and I hope you enjoyed this episode, and also subscribe for the next episode that is going to be lighter. And as we end off in this creepy thing, I'm just going to run out of here because this is creepy. Just too plain creepy. Hooray! Plain daylight! You're still alive! Let's murder you!